And I felt like I was the only one who saw this. That was what made it so difficult. Hey friends, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Serena. I've been vegan since birth. And today I'm talking to you about a little bit more of my story of growing up vegan, what that was like when I was really little in the 90s, early 90s, and what I found to be the hardest part about growing up vegan. So this is my story. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button below right now if you like my content, because I really, really appreciate your support and help in getting a message of peace, compassion, nonviolence, and veganism out into the world. If you saw my previous video where I talked about getting my own food choices when I was 7 years old, and I've linked it right up here, you probably heard me talk about education and how I had these note cards and I had to learn all these different ingredients before I got my own food choices. Well, the reality is that was not my first education. My family, we were not just vegan or just following a vegan diet or just living a vegan lifestyle. We brought it into everything we did and we talked about it all the frickin' time. Literally, all the time, no joke. From when I was very, very little, through when I was 7, through when I was older, through today. It's been a huge part of my life, especially because my mom was the founder of the vegetarian vegan group in our city in the early 1990s, was involved in activism. We attended national vegan conferences on a yearly basis, and we had a lot of local potluck groups and events and did vegan education. And my mom always brought us into that. So I was part of that, helping do activism, helping leaflet, attending protests, all of these things from a really early age. And we also talked about why we were doing it. We had a lot of animal activists and vegan activists that were traveling through town or coming to speak in our area, and they would stay at our house and we'd get to talk to them and, you know, ask them questions about their experiences and why they were doing what they were doing. So I grew up with this, and it started, you know, when we were really little, talking about how mother cows, their milk was for baby cows. Mother cat's milk was for kittens. And that's why we didn't want to take anyone else's milk. So we'd have conversations like that, which are very sort of understandable for a small child. And then as we got older, it was conversations about, oh, that veggie burger, that veggie hot dog we're eating, that's different than the hot dogs or the burgers over there that your friends are eating. And here's why. We love animals, we don't want to hurt them. And if you put them in a burger, you know, they had to die for that. That hurts them. As I got a little bit older, you know, the thing that comes up is if we're talking about how we don't want to hurt animals, we love them, we don't want to eat them, well, why do my friends eat animals then? Do they want to hurt animals, or why do they do it? And the way my parents framed it was this idea of education. It was, well, we understand, we know this information, so we choose differently. They don't know, they don't understand, they don't have this information yet, so they don't know any better. Which, it works to explain this to a small child, but as I got older, it became really difficult for me to wrap my head around the fact that other good, caring people around me couldn't see what I saw, didn't live the way that I did. And it's not that I had a problem being different. I was actually very proud to be different. It didn't bother me. But it was because I understood why we were vegan. My passion has always been to spread peace and nonviolence. As I got older, of course, I started educating them with everything. I would bring flyers, I would talk to them, I would, you know, tell them what went into a hot dog, what went into gelatin, what went into these things. Sometimes I got responses that was, oh, wow, that's so sad, or I didn't know, or, you know. And I did have a lot of friends that did want to go vegetarian or quit eating certain things because of the information I shared with them. But then others would say, oh, whatever, and, you know, continue to pop it in their mouth. And I couldn't fathom that. That was what was so difficult for me. And granted, I knew so much more information, so many more details than my friends did. I grew up with it and I was living it, but I still just couldn't get why, when people learned and were presented with this information, didn't want to change. Even today, I have a hard time understanding how people that truly care about justice, nonviolence, other social issues in our world, continue to support violence towards animals. That, in fact, is what has been hardest about growing up vegan, It's being in these environments where people act normally, behave normally, talk about peace and justice in other areas of their life, and then sit down to a dead animal, sit down to the body and flesh of what were once living, sentient beings. I've always lived with this knowledge, and that, I guess, maybe is the downside of raising children vegan. It is something that I'm very aware of. I look at the world through such a different lens, and it was so hard for me to wrap my head around this as a child, to understand how people I loved and cared about, who said they loved animals, who cared about compassion and peace, were supporting something that I knew to be so awful. And I felt like I was the only one who saw this. That was what made it so difficult, is I felt like I had a pair of glasses or goggles that, you know, took the film off the world, and I could see something that literally everyone around me, aside from the vegans in my life, couldn't see. And it was that bizarre feeling of, how do I break through this? How do I shed that? How do I share what I know? Give someone else those goggles or glasses to help them see what I see, to see the atrocities and violence that are going on such a huge scale every single day of our lives that we are all, if we're not vegan, supporting. That has truly been the most difficult thing, for how do I stay connected to, communicate with these people that I care about, maintain these relationships, and not become so demoralized, not become so overwhelmed. But I do want to say, I really do have hope. So in saying this, this is what I found most difficult. But at the same time, I have immense hope. And that's why I haven't given up, because I have seen progress, I have seen people change, and I believe education really does work and is powerful. And the difference in veganism and how it was received in the early 90s to today is absolutely incredible. And I am truly hopeful that we can and will change the world. I just want to share with you a deeper understanding of why I and probably many vegans do what we do, behave the way we do, and feel so compelled to talk about veganism, share this information, share the reality of what happens to animals all the time, even when it seems uncomfortable, even when you just want to sit and enjoy your meal. This is why, because we don't see food, we see violence. We see harm, we see atrocities on an unimaginable scale and level that no one else can see or is paying attention to. All right, so that's all I've got for you guys. Keep up hope, and please drop me a comment below and tell me, what did you think? What is the hardest part for you about being vegan or going vegan? And maybe I can give you some tips and help you, keep you motivated, because guess what? The world is changing, a vegan world is coming. I really, truly believe that, and we can all make it happen. I'll see you next week.